give you a briefing about the institution?
All I know is it's a mental hospital.
For the criminally insane.
Leonardo DiCaprio doesn't know if he's going to get off the island alive in Shutter Island, the new thriller by Martin Scorsese, an eerie psychological thriller that succeeds in performing the same kinds of effects you get from haunted house tours. It evokes a grim, dark mood on an isolated, water-bordered mental hospital where U.S. Marshals DiCaprio and Mark Ruffalo investigate the whereabouts of a missing patient. The mysterious Ben Kingsley is the head doctor who tries a number of techniques in diagnosing these patients.
These are all violent defenders, right? I mean, they've hurt people. Murdered them in some cases.
In almost all cases, yes.
And personally, Doctor, I'd have to say screw their sense of calm.
And DiCaprio is still recovering from trauma during his days as a soldier in World War II and other tragedies, and he experiences a lot of hallucinations, worn out by the creepy corridors of the hospital and the constant raindrops. Max von Sydow is Kingsley's associate and needs only one sentence to show us that he has a secret agenda.
You ever seen a death camp doctor? Ein Konzentrationslager. Huh? Ich war dabei. Bei der Befreiung von Dachau. Ihr Englisch ist sehr gut, fast perfekt. His English really is very good. You hit the consonants a tad hard, though.
Movie might not add up neatly first time around, with things occurring out of order, being replayed and shown through the eyes of different characters, but in an early season where we have countless dumb slasher movies, I am grateful enough for a movie that creates a psychologically convincing atmosphere, and credit goes to Scorsese, and you're in the hands of a pro like him and the art direction. Leonardo DiCaprio projects a lot of intensity and heavy burden, and the supporting characters are all well drawn out too, and take on new wacky dimensions that I cannot reveal because it is all part of the twist. Eric?
Shutter Island is another film that displays Scorsese's mastery of storytelling. The overarching theme that I got from this film is the theme of trust. It is trusting the officials, the workers, partners, and overall trusting yourself and trusting your own mind.
Mm-hmm.
Teddy starts to lose trust in all of these things, which allows the plot to move forward.
Oh, it sure does. You know, Scorsese does a good job at establishing that hierarchy in the hospital, with the medical staff and the orderlies. Even at one point, DiCaprio questions all of them in the beginning of the film. Even the prison warden and the guards, I mean, you take them at face value in their uniforms, and that trust that you talked about, you're right, it goes out the window.
The pace is rather slow at first, but picks up to a mind-numbing rhythm that leaves viewers unable to wait for what's to come. It surely left me on the edge of my seat. The twist at the end was unfortunately predictable.
Oh no, I don't think so.
Until what happens after that twist, then you won't be able to say much more than something along the lines of, are you serious?
I did not see the ending coming, and of course it comes down to this. Furthermore, I'm not sure anyone would be able to give it away.
I'm not too sure about that.
Because it comes at you in strands and bits and pieces, it's a mind game, and even a few, not me, but a few, could see the ending coming.
Mm-hmm.
I can't really say it's cheating, because like you said, it could be a dream, because it shows a demonstration of what a certain character in this movie, who I will not name, is trying to perform to modify a certain something.
All in all, everything was on point. Plot moved along nicely, shots were beautifully composed, and the acting was great. So, for me, Shutter Island gets 4.5 Vans out of 5.